The focus of this lesson is on using synthetic division to divide a polynomial by another polynomial. You've already used long division in the past to accomplish the same task. With synthetic division, however, there are specific criteria in order to be able to even perform synthetic division. And the main criteria is that the divisor has to be of the form x minus a. And just to remind you who the divisor is, it's the one you're dividing by. And so it has to be of the form x minus a. So if it is not, then you're going to want to do long division. So let me give you an example. Suppose I ask you to take the polynomial of y to the fifth, etc., divided by y to the second. You should immediately realize that you are not able to perform synthetic division. And the reason being is look at that y to the second. It's to the second power. It's not degree one. So you are not of the form y minus a constant. So because of that, you would have to do long division to do this problem. And for the sake of this video, we will not go into that. I just wanted to identify that for you, as it is your job going forward to know when you can and cannot use synthetic division. As we mentioned before, synthetic division can only be used if the divisor is of the form x minus a. So some examples of what that means is, let's say you're given the divisor x minus 2. In that case, who's being subtracted off? 2. So a is 2. In the case x plus 2 as the divisor, who's being subtracted off? Negative 2. So a is negative 2. So I always tell students you can look at it as what value is subtracted off, or you can look at it as kind of opposite of what you see, but you have to be in that form, x minus a. Let's go ahead and take our degree 5 polynomial and divide it by x plus 2. So note that the divisor is x plus 2, so it is of the form x minus a, where your a in this case is negative 2. So you're subtracting off negative 2 from x, so that's your a value. And note that we're going to basically set up a division bracket where we have a dividend and we have a divisor, but in the divisor position we're going to put our a, and under the in the dividend position we're going to put our coefficients of our dividend. So what we do with synthetic division is we pull down the very first coefficient. So we don't do anything with it other than we pull it directly down. And then what I would like you to do is draw a horizontal line across, and anything that falls below this horizontal line will multiply by our a value, negative 2. And anything above this line will add together with our coefficients. Okay? And so the way synthetic division works is you pull down that very first digit of 2 and you multiply it by your a value. So when you multiply 2 times negative 2, you get negative 4. So then put that above the line, and now that you're above the line, you're going to add those results. So 4 and negative 4 makes 0. When you fall below the line, you're going to multiply it by your a. So 0 times negative 2 is 0. When you fall above the line, you're going to go ahead and add your coefficient to your result, and you get negative 3. You're now below the line, so you're going to multiply by your a. So negative 3 times negative 2 is a positive 6. You're now above the line, you're going to go ahead and add, and you get negative 1. You're below the line, so you multiply by your a. Negative 1 times negative 2 is a positive 2. So take 3 plus 2, you get 5. Take 5 and multiply it by your a. 5 times negative 2 is negative 10. And so note that negative 2 and a negative 10 combine to negative 12. So what you actually did is you performed division, even though you may not quite know that yet. And this first piece here is your quotient, and this second piece here is your remainder. And so what happens is you did take your divisor, x plus 2, so we'll write it in the form x minus a negative 2, and you divided that into 2x to the 5th plus 4x to the 4th minus 3x cubed minus 7x squared plus 3x minus 2. And you got, as a result, a quotient that begins with a coefficient of 2, and it's going to be 1 degree less than your dividend. So it'll be 2x to the fourth. And that'll always be the case. It'll always be 1 degree less, because when you take your leading term and you divide it by x, it's going to give you a result of 1 degree less. And then the following coefficients will be in descending order of power your next term. So plus 0x cubed, which normally I wouldn't write, but for the sake of this video and learning, let's put it there. And then minus 3x to the second minus 1x, which normally I would write minus x, plus 5. And so that is your quotient. And then your remainder is negative 12. So you can write minus 12 over your divisor, because you always put your remainder over your divisor. And since we're a negative, I went ahead and put a minus sign. If it was a positive, I would have put a plus sign. And so that is my result when I perform synthetic division.